rumors spreading round. And that takes the time. But the shack outside the games. And you know what I'm talking about. Just let me know if you wanna go to that home out on the range. They got a lot of nice girls.
Welcome to Sports Vision, the magazine. Joe, I can't believe a guy is that old and looks that good. Palo and Mike, I can't believe a guy is that old. Craigan, along with Fajita.
Yeah, it looks that good. Hey, I got my Valentine's
you do have
Day
your
look,
val,
my
your
once
val.
A year tie that I wear.
Your
once
val
a year tie wearer. Anyway, yeah,
Fajita,
we got Fajita.
Bear. Craigan, Fajita,
and
Palo.
The Bears. That's what we're doing.
We got the Bears. Tall Bears.
They won a state championship this weekend.
We've got Mark.
Yep.
Matthew, Luke, John, back here.
All
Paul,
of them.
George, Ringo, they're all back here.
Got a roll here. We have great action, mostly to do with wrestling.
Action.
The state title came to Cleveland, Tennessee.
Rappling.
Once again, and we got the Bradley
but
Bears.
They don't call it that anymore.
We're going to show you how they went after it, and we got a long interview with Coach Logsdon because this is his last year. Special little interview, and maybe another surprise or two
last
on this
year.
Happy
it
Valentine's
is last year. Kidding
Day
everybody.
Weekend. Let's go to Clarksville, take the last train and see what happened.
Meet you at the station.
Right here, before they took off, they got in the locker room, and the cheerleaders had a little surprise for them, a little send-off, decoration. School rained out that day. They usually send off the bus provided by Mr. Alan Jones of Check and the Cash, gave them a charter to head to Clarksville Inn.
And the girls went and did that.
And the girls went and did this. We love you. And there's Mr. West and Mr. Craigan. Good luck, Bears. And right there they are. Look at that. The support was there. The crowd was crazy. Check this out. Soddy Daisy cheerleaders did a little challenge. Backflips, all of them. We'll check out with the Bradley Bear cheer. We didn't whip them on the mat. We whipped them on the cheerleading mat. Check this out.
All right, let's see it here. Come on, girls.
You hear this mat sound here. We've got a lot of action going on there. Here it is. Getting ready. Getting ready.
We got some.
You talk about excitement. This got the crowds going. It really did. If you can hear the mat sounds, the crowd.
Later on tonight, let's do that.
Okay.
Want to do that?
And check this out. Little man.
Hey.
Bradley got in there. But look at their challenging, and it just is pretty exciting. This is all before the match. Everybody's waiting. They're getting excited.
And I'll be impressed when I see Logsdon do that. Can he do that? That flip like that?
And look at the crowd. Now, they sent out all the seniors because this is their last shot at the team title. Of course, we've got the individual coming up. But look at all the seniors out there. And Tony, check that out. Great little sign. All right, first match. Here we go. Matt Bailey. They had the draw at 215, and that was a key match because the first time through, we wrestled Soddy. We won the match, but we did not win this particular bout right here. And this was huge because Soddy was making some changes in their lineup to try to get the Bears thrown off and win a couple matchups. And this is a matchup that they won big at last time, but this Bear right here, Matt Bailey, turned it around. Huge start for the Bears because it was a 9-point swing our direction. Here comes Sean Grady. They also moved the regular heavyweight off of him, a younger, smaller, lighter guy that they thought could move better and go with Grady. And he ends up with a big win, 6-5. We go to 103 now, and this is Tanner Johnson wrestling the formerly number one ranked 103 pounder in the state from Soddy McCroskey, but Tanner does lose, but we're showing everybody, even on their high moments, because Tanner Johnson puts him on his back right there, but does not win the match. So 2-1. Now we got Blake Kinsley at 112 come in, and he took care of his man in a major right here at 112. Blake Kinsley, and then we have two key matches coming up right after Blake gets his win here. Sean Cordell, they moved super soft Ryan Fuller on to Sean Cordell coming up. We're going to have a few tape scratches here, so keep it rolling, Mark. We didn't edit quite right, but we've got Blake here getting some final points on his 112-pounder from Saudi, and then we're going to show Sean Cordell coming up right after this. He is going to have Mark Fuller's a Bradley guy. There's Sean.
Mark didn't appreciate that.
There's Ryan Fuller, and there's Sean getting some points right there in a hard-fought 5-2 match. Sean's going to get out right here. Nice switch. Look at him keep moving. He tries to re-switch, and he switches him right back. Great job by Sean Cordell. Then the number one ranked guy in the state of Tennessee at 125 coming up is also the number seven ranked guy in the nation, senior Kyle James, coming up right here after you see Sean win with Travis Cragen. And Travis Cragen took him down, first takedown of the season. This guy had not been taken down all year. He's going to get taken down here. And time ran out on Travis as he was taking him to his back. And that's the once in, you know, this guy is so good. That's one of those opportunities to get him in the position you want him. To maybe pull off this would have been the talk of the tournament. I had a Macaulay guy tell me we were watching that. It was 4-4 after the first period. James did go on to win in the major, but the Saudi kid is tough, and we're getting ready to turn him here. Keep it going. Time runs out right here as we're taking him to his back and legs. And he's almost ready to count backwards. So there it is. But Kyle James does go on to win, and here we have Jake West. Jake sporting the Mohawk. And he's going to take his opponent. They switched the guy down on him from a higher weight. So a little bit stronger kid, because Jake was able to pin the original opponent from the regular season match. And they brought this guy down. And Jake ended up taking care of him in a regular decision. This guy was real strong. They were having him go out there and stall out, not get pinned. There's a lot of strategy to try to get the points made up from the 21-point lead that Bradley was able to finish with in the first time around. So Jake West, looking good right here, going to end up getting a takedown and ends up winning his match. Here's another takedown. But you can hear the excitement in the background, and watch the Saudi kids on the bench now. They're starting to realize that it's not going their way. And a key match coming up after this, Ryan Ensminger. They moved John Lane off of Ryan Ensminger to go up and wrestle who they thought was going to be Jesse Baker. They moved this kid down, who was Jesse Baker's guy, gave Jesse a real tough match. Ryan Ensminger and Matt Bailey, two key matches. I showed you the first one, Matt Bailey, right at the beginning, getting a big swing. They thought they were going to win, maybe pin here, and Ensminger wrestled lights out. And the camera doesn't follow, but after this match was over, he ran and jumped on Coach Logson, and Logson lifted him up in the air high. But watch this action, really a scramble. That's the first takedown. Looked like he was in trouble. Gets the guy to his back here. Look at the Saudi people. They can't believe what's going on. Coach can't. Look at now. See, they thought they had it going their way, and here it is. He gets him back over again and ends up here. Late in the first period, he's going to end up with a pin right here. Watch this. I mean, he just wrestled lights out. Nobody thought this was going to happen. We were confident he could win, but we surely didn't expect a pin here. And everything changed. That was it for Saudi. And we're about halfway through the match right here, and they knew it was over. Look at their kids on the bench, heading their chins and chins in their hand. They know it's done. Kyle James looking at, you know, can't believe they're losing this. And right here is where we're going to get the pin. Good feel right here. Guy's going to sit up right there, going to hit the cradle right now on his knees with his head tucked under, taking him over. Watch the reaction as he realizes he just won a huge match to help the Bears win a duels title. Going to get the mat slapped right here. And it is going to happen. There's a Saudi cheerleader saying no, please no, and there it is. And look at Ryan. Great excitement and a great win. That was a big win. He'll never forget that one right there. We move on here. Now to our 145-pound match. This is Matt Spain with Craig Potter. Spain is going to pull out of what looked to be a headlock score by Potter. He's going to get some points. He did lose a decision here to Craig Potter, who's one of the top-ranked kids at 145 at Saudi. But we're going to show you the highlights for Matt right here as he ends up getting some scores. He did a good job, fought back, and really until the third period, it was a close match. And now we go with Justin Spain. They moved the guy that usually wrestles Quinn down because they knew the guy wouldn't beat Quinn, and he was strong, and they figured maybe he'd come down and beat the freshman. Well, the freshman showed him right here, you're not going to beat me. Lots of struggle, lots of muscle. Justin had a hard time dealing with the 4 years experience and muscle difference because this is a senior, but Justin ended up being able to pull out a win here. You're going to show him score. As you can tell, it's going to take him a little bit. This isn't the same guy he wrestled and was able to pin the first time around. society doing a lot of juggling, trying to get the matchups where they felt they could get the young guys or the guys that weren't quite the, what they expected to be. But Bradley is tough up and down. And where they thought they were going to win, our guys stepped up and took it away. And Justin even gets some back points here. And that, you saw the takedown, plus three right here, and he won the match 5-0. So this is all the scoring in this match. And Justin Spain, big match right here. Paul Campbell has wrestled Josh Cooper. Watch the headbutts. Look at the ref's going to stop and penalize the Saudi guy. Paul Campbell and Josh Cooper have had several battles. Josh Cooper has come out on the wrong end of several, okay? We'll see if Josh is fired up on this one. And he ends up right here coming up. They go out of bounds. He's all over the guy, but he gets hurt right there. So Saudi will forfeit the match, but Cooper was taking it to him. You can see how pumped up he is. This was it. Last time there. I mean, you hear the excitement in the background. They're going to forfeit. That's the match. Bradley, seventh straight duels championship. Great coach right there, Steve Henry. Steve Henry from Saudi. Got a lot of respect for that guy. Coach Logson has a lot of respect for that guy. And look at the crowd come in. They were pumped. You're going to see the celebration, a little bit of the post-celebration going on.
So Saudi is what now? Like what, seventh? What are they ranked?
They're ranked behind McCauley, Father Ryan, and Baylor. So I think they're like fifth or sixth. Look at that. Trip to Clarksville, $40, blah, 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 blah. But Coach Logson's last dual state title, priceless. And it was. Now listen to the chant. Logson, they're going to pick him up. Listen to the chant now in the background. He got a lot of, there it is. And let's listen as they chant Logston, Logston, Logston. Getting ready to go with it here.
Yeah, buddy.
A lot of respect. His last.
You know what? Right after that particular match right there, he could have ran for Bradley County Mayor.
That's right.
Gary Davis needs to watch out.
That's right. And I tell you, what a great way to go out. He's not finished, and we'll talk about that a little bit later in the show. There's a lot of people to do with Bradley Wrestling
out. Alan just wanted to hug him. That's
Alan Morris. Well, he's been a big part with that kids club. And then Coach Laxton right there in the background. Lots of celebration. We're going to show you in a little bit. It continues on, but they're going to hand out the awards. There's Chuck Blackman. Bryant Blackman, who was injured in that match, will be able to go, by the way. So the interview you see later, questioning Bryant's ability to wrestle this coming week, he will be able to go. So I'll tell you that up front. Coach Ben Smith, all the parents were down there, grandparents were there. There's Ronnie Carter, head of TSSAA. Went through your screen. We'll see him again in a minute. But there's a lot of parents. The support was fantastic. Coach Logson has thanked over and over to me to make sure I let him know. Check this out. Teresa West. You know where Jake gets his silliness at. Look at Teresa. Get in front of those guys.
Not sporting them.
Now watch this, though. Now watch this. They're going to show us the other side here, which is kind of cute. There we go. But those are senior weight classes on the back. Jesse Baker didn't get a wrestle. He was injured. And Blake Kinsley and Tanner Johnson giving a hug right there. Josh Cooper in the background, Chris Brady, Quinn Gibson, the Mighty Quinn, and Miss Olinger right there. Everybody sees her in the office. Tanner Johnson and a beef jerky. So I'm going to give one to my buddy Travis right here. He can eat one too. And they're enjoying the fact that they are state champions. There's Withrow in the background. His son's
wrestling. Yep, Withrow.
And here they are. They're going to give it to Coach Logston, the coach's plaque of the number one, the coach of the number one state team in the state of Tennessee, gladly accepting. And Saudi, look at the respect the Saudi kids. You got to give a lot of credit. Look at the respect they're giving Coach Logston. That's the other team right there. But they know this man's on his way out, and there's a lot of respect to Coach Logston. And then they're going to give the Bradley Bears. They're going to go get their trophy, and there they are. Even some of the little Bears in the kids' club hanging around there. Cheerleaders are going to get in on the action. And just a great celebration. I want to give you a feel for the whole thing. Right there.
Then the famous pose.
Their famous pose. Of course, same two guys. Always got to get in front and lay down in the, fold-out spread right there. And here we come.
They're always at the same angle.
That's right. Then we're going to get the point. And I don't know what that means. It's just tradition to get everybody that's looking at them looking the other way for some reason. Great weekend. The cheerleaders jump in, get another little picture. And we're going to move on to the bus. There they are at the hotel. Everybody drove to the hotel, even those that weren't staying, and waited for the bus to get there after they packed up. And they had pizza and sodas and just a great time there. Up till about 4 in the morning. I guess I'm not telling anything out of school. They were just having a great time celebrating Coach Logson's final state dual title. We're going to talk to Coach Logson in a little bit. We're going to show you some graphics coming up here just right away. And it'll be tell us the actual story of how they got to the road to the state final. But there it is.
There you go.
Bradley Central Bears.
There you go. The state duels champion, Bradley Central Bears, as they beat Marvel 53-30. Bradley over Soddy, as you saw, 38-22. And then, of course, Bradley wins
over Franklin
46-22 over Franklin.
And that Franklin match was the middle match. Of course, the final was the Soddy match. And how about that? All right.
How about that?
You know what that means? That means, I've said it several times in the piece, 7th state duels, 12th state title overall, looking for 13 in the traditional list.
12 in how many years?
And he's been coaching, I think, for just 12 years.
12 years.
Yeah, he's averaging one a year. That's a great record.
No kidding.
And guess what? We told you about that coming up. Look at this. Live on Fox 61, we're going to show the state wrestling tournament 4-7 Saturday, February 21st. So all those great Bradley wrestlers are all going to compete. Several of them are going to be in the finals. You watch.
I believe they got that picture of me taking you down there.
I know it. You know, I'm never going to forget that. I don't know.
But I know.
I don't know. But listen,
we
got to go to the commercial. I'm going to go to Southern Grill and have something to eat first.
Yeah.
And then we're going to
come back.
We'll come back. Be back after this break.
Hi, I'm Steve McNair, and you're watching Sports Vision on WTNB.
So when I heard Hardee's was making their hamburgers out of Angus beef, well, I just flat out didn't believe it. I mean, I've raised Angus beef for 25 years, and I know how expensive it is. Yeah, I just couldn't figure out how they could afford to put Angus beef in their hamburger. So I went into town to try it out. Boy, you could have knocked me over with a feather. They're serving Angus beef hamburgers.
Thick burgers with 100% Angus beef. It's how the last place you'd go for a burger will become the first.
Checking the cash, checking the cash.
You got a cash emergency, you got a money mayday. We cash your personal check and then we hold it till your payday.
Checking the cash.
You wanna get your money in a hurry, in a flash. You want it from a friendly place that's got a lot of class.
Checking the cash, checking the cash.
Sports Vision, the magazine. That was great wrestling.
It was good action, and we're going to talk about it here with Coach Logsdon, but right before we get started.
Congratulations, Bradley Bears, by
yes,
way.
Sir. Let me tell you, you people out there, Michigan Avenue and Blythe Bower girls and the Ross and Waterville boys, we taped you the other night. We're going to show you next week, so don't hang on.
We got another game tonight.
That's right. We got another game tonight. We're going to get that whole tournament in there, so hang on, and don't be too mad. We'll show you next
week. But it'll be on next week.
That's right. So let's go. We're going to interview the coach, Papa Bear, the man who is the 7th straight duels title winner. As a coach. Here we go.
I'm sitting here with the head coach of the state champion, once again, of the duels, Bradley Central Bears. And we broke tradition a little bit this year. Usually the night of the state championship, we've held an interview in the hotel room. But lots of reason to celebrate, lots of things going on. Really not a good place or time to do it, but we caught up with Steve Logsdon. This is now Sunday morning after, but still feels pretty good, doesn't it, Coach?
It feels great.
Congratulations.
Thank you. I woke up this morning, it's a great feeling. In all my years, we've been lucky enough to be successful. Wake up the morning of and your eyes pop open, and every time it's the first thought that creeps into your mind is that state title, and it's over and you've got it, and it's a great feeling.
It is a great feeling, and it wasn't easy, obviously. We had a Maryville team, which that wasn't quite the challenge that we knew it was coming up. But we went to Franklin, and they had 5 or 6 pretty good kids that are highly regarded kids, and gave us some battles in some places. And we had a couple people get injured, and I know that kind of, even though we felt good, we had a little bit of uneasiness about maybe having a couple guys that weren't being able to compete. Tell us a little bit about that, moving on before we got to the Soddy match.
Well, you know, Maryville's a young team. We knew they weren't as experienced as a lot of teams we've wrestled this year, but Franklin is an up-and-coming team. They have 5 returning state place winners, as you said, and they're well coached. They're just a tough team, and I look for good things for them in the future. But we wrestled pretty well against them for the most part. We lost some close matches I didn't like to lose. But, you know, like you said, the 2 injuries stands out in my mind. You know, you hate to think about losing a kid like Bryant Blackman with his ankle injury there. You hate thinking about losing Jesse Baker, his collarbones. It's very tender. They're going to go tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock and get x-rayed over at Tri-State, and we're going to find out what we have to work with. And you hate to think about Brian not being able to wrestle, because he's come so far in the last even 3 and 4 years. You know, Brian has just changed, you know, from this little kid into a full-grown man, and he's got goals and things he's worked toward, and he deserves that opportunity to get to pursue that, and I hope he does.
We hope to see him in the state championship, and then if he is and he's healthy, we hope to see him as a very good shot at a state champion. So we wish Brian the best on that. We came to the Saudi match then, and you know, overall, of course, Coach Steve Henry's always got something up his sleeve. I don't know if anybody thought he was going to do some of the things he did.
But before the match, the coaches and I talked about the matchups, and we tried to anticipate what we'd do if that was our situation. If we were wrestling against Bradley, how would we line our guys up against him? And we got pretty close on some of the guesses. And but, you know, Jesse Baker also was injured in the Franklin match, his collarbone. We knew he couldn't wrestle, but we tried to throw him a head fake there and let him go ahead and dress out and go ahead and warm up like he was going to wrestle. And then we had Mark Fuller waiting in the wings there. But really, we were pretty much limited with our ability to bump, because I don't want to bump anyone out of the lineup and maybe swap places. But with what they were going to do, we anticipated we didn't have to do a lot of bumping around, just wrestle, you know, hard-nosed style of match. And when did they come out with some little tricks up their sleeve? And they did. But, you know, as you stated, a couple matches were huge. And just after the match, Steve Henry and I are good friends, and we talked. And he said that, you know, those were backbreakers. So the 135 was a backbreaker for him. You know, Ryan wrestled like a champ.
He did.
He'd come out,
good.
Dropping down a weight class. He was trying to muscle Ryan around, intimidate him, and Ryan had no part of that. And he pinned him, and then Matt Bailey was a huge match. Our heavyweight, Sean Grady, fought great match. They bumped a kid there. It was more athletic than their other heavyweight, and it was a good move for them. And Sean really fought like a champ and wrestled great. And then a little backbreaker for him, too, was when they bumped their senior 60-pounder down to 152. And going to take on our freshman. And Justin Spain just went out there and just wrestled like a champ and took it to him. And that was took the wind out of their sail, so to speak, really. Kind of maybe drove that final nail into their coffin, because after that you got Quinn Gibson to deal with, and Bryant Blackman, and even injured Bryant Blackman's a tough kid. And then we got Josh Cooper, who, you know, he's got a real rivalry going with Paul Campbell over the years.
He looked like he was going to get that. He did get it as far
as he's close to
the gap. But he was there on that one.
Yeah, his mind is in this thing. I look for great things from Josh Cooper in the next 2 weeks in the region and state tournament. He's on fire.
Well, that's seven duels, correct? Seven duels titles for Coach Logsdon. As you know, this is his last time to do that in Clarksville. It's kind of a tradition. We love it. We're going up there every year. I think we're going to be back next year, but he'll be back as a fan, and he's done a great job over the years, and we want to make sure he gets credit for what he's done here to help build this tradition of Bradley that we have going here. And they still have one more piece of business coming up in 2 weeks. Actually, it starts this week with the regions, but then we move on to the state, and it's 11. It could be 12, and I really think the prospects are good for that.
Well, I hope we're not done yet. I hope that the guys don't feel satisfied, because we have the dual tournament under our belts, and we should be satisfied with that part. But now there's the traditional tournament, time for individual glory and time to, you know, for those of these guys to further stake their claim on being a great team, and you have to follow it up in 2 weeks. And, you know, let me say one thing about this past weekend. You know, the guys did a great job, you know, but I think our fans were great. Our fans were outstanding. We had a lot of people. Made the trip. A lot of kids body painted up, and a lot of mamas wearing colored shirts and dads, and they were just loud, and it was a lot of fun. You know, I was sitting there before the match, and they were doing the cheerleaders tumbling back and forth with each other, and the fans were chanting back and forth. And, you know, me and Coach Laxton looked at each other there and said, you know, how many guys our age get to come to work and have this much fun?
Mm-hmm.
You know, and it's a great thing. And I also want to thank Alan Jones, provided us with a charter bus to go up there. That's something that we were the only charter bus up there at that tournament. Everybody else is in little school vans and buses and stuff. And when he provides that for us each year as he has, he doesn't know how much that means to the team, how much they can relax and the coaches can relax. And I just want to thank him publicly for that.
Does take care of the rest
yes,
of us around this community. Does a lot for them. Well, working on 12, and we wish you good luck in the next 2 weeks. We're going to have on whatever the results are, and we're hoping for a 12 state championship, 11 this weekend. It was a lot of fun. If you weren't there, we're obviously going to show you the highlights here in just a minute. So, Coach Lawson, congratulations.
Thank you.
Logsdon.
All right. Hey, you know, real quickly, I said 12th. That was the 12th state championship.
The 12th.
They're working on 13 this weekend.
Yep.
And we got to welcome this. Happy Valentine's Day, Joe, to our lovely wives, Kim Palo and Denise Cragen, from the Men of Their Dreams.
Now, hopefully,
to you and me.
Hopefully they know it's us and not, you know, because Kim.
Oh, that's right. That's right.
Kim sweats and salivates every time she sees Alan Jones.
I know. And Denise has thought Tom Rowland. She just can't wait to stroke his head sometime. And I don't know why.
I don't know what's up with
so,
that.
Yeah, I don't anyway. Either. So wait a minute. We better
salivate.
Alter that graph. There we go.
All right.
From your husbands. Let's
Ooh,
get it
whoever
right.
they may be.
All right. Happy Valentine's Day, you lovely women. We love you. We're going to be right back.
on its own, money is not smart. It needs instruction, guidance, like the kind offered at First Tennessee. Our financial professionals help you straighten out retirement plans, get a loan, plan for college, and get your financial goals in order so your money has what it takes to wise up and work harder. And that's smart. First Tennessee, all things financial.
Coming live Saturday, February 21st to WDSI Fox 61, it's the 2004 TSSAA State Wrestling Tournament. Watch it live on WDSI Fox 61 as D1 schools battle it out to see who is crowned state champion. Join host Mike Cregan and Danny Gilbert as they bring you every second of the match. The 2004 TSSAA State Wrestling Tournament, live Saturday, February 21st, brought to you by SportsVision and sponsored by Check Into Cash.
You're not going to want to miss that.
That's it for the show for this week.
Yes, and Valentine's Day, happy weekend.
Happy Valentine's
Day.
Joe
and I, that's very special to us because one time we were a gift to the mayor. And
we started Valentine's Day.
You made a very good heart.
You made a very good Cupid.
Let's show you that on the way out. We'll see you next week.
Have a good week.
To our esteemed mayor.
What's up with that?
And we came to say a couple things, and we appreciate all of you being here tonight. There's so many lovely faces out there. I just can't find them. Okay, now.
Which arrow?
What kind do you have there?
I have a straight arrow. See, they're pointing the right way. And I have one that's, it's not so straight.
Shoot that one. Shoot that one. Oh, that was wonderful. That was a wonderful shot. We have a special song we want to sing to you, sir. First of all, may I give you these flowers? Oh, I love the way you take them. Yes, we have a very special song for you. Did you bring your harmonica?
I left her in Washington.
One, two. Happy Valentine's to you. Happy Valentine's to you. Two very good reasons, excuse me. That was the first one. First of all, we all want to say that we are so pleased in how Mr. Mayor is doing so well after his surgery. The first reason. The second reason is I have this huge heart on.
He's always bragging.
Well, city council. So do with me what you will, just be gentle. Show you this is the best outing they've had.